Welcome, my dear students. We'll continue with the next class of microprocedures application course. So in this class, we'll discuss the next group of instruction, that is program control instructions. Program control instructions include jump group of instructions. There are two types of jump group instructions: unconditional jump, conditional jump. Program control instructions. As you know that controlling the program flow is very important thing. This is where the program can make decisions based on the conditions. So program control instructions change or modify the flow of a program, that is transfers control from the normal sequential execution to the specified destination instructions or the target instruction. So this is called program control instructions. So program control instructions include jump group of instructions. Jump instructions are classified into two groups: unconditional jump. Then what is unconditional jump? In unconditional jump, control is transferred unconditionally to the target label, which points to the address of the target instruction. That is, transfers control unconditionally, that is independent of any condition, to another instruction. So these are called unconditional jump instructions. So examples of unconditional jump instructions include JMP, stands for jump, call instruction, return instructions. Okay. So if you observe the diagram here, an example of unconditional jump. Okay. So this is the main program, which consists of three parts: part one, part two, part three. So in part one of the program, we are making an unconditional jump. So JMP followed by the label. Label is AAA. So this unconditional jump instruction transfers control unconditional to the specified target instruction. Then these set of instructions will be executed, which are in part three. Okay. And then instructions in the part two skipped due to a jump. So note that in unconditional jump, the program will execute instructions at the jump label and will not return to the instruction following the jump instruction. Then second type of jump group, conditional jump. So in conditional jump, control is transferred to the target label if a certain condition is met. Otherwise, execution continues with next sequential instruction. The conditions are represented by flags. Okay. So example of conditional jump instruction: JC, jump if carry or jump on carry. JZ, jump on zero. JNC, jump if no carry. JNZ, jump if no or jump if not zero. So in unconditional jump, control is transferred to the label if a certain condition is met. So otherwise, execution continues with the next sequential instruction. So this diagram depicts the conditional jumps. So this is the main program, which consists of part one, part two, and part three. we are in part one of the program. We are making a conditional jump. Okay, so then immediately if it will jump to the target label if certain condition is met. If condition is met, yes, go and execute the instruction at the jump level. If no, condition is not met, execution continues with the next sequential instruction after the condition instruction. So if the condition is met, this part 2 of the instruction is skipped. Let us discuss in detail. First, the unconditional jump instruction. One such unconditional jump instruction is JMP, stands for jump. The general form of JMP instruction is jump label, where label is a program address identifier. Okay. So this instruction unconditionally transfer control of execution to the specified label or address using an 8-bit or 16-bit displacement or CS:IP, a new segment and offset address. See that this label is an 8-bit or 16-bit displacement or CS:IP, a combination of CS and IP. Okay, so actually, so this is an offset address for the instruction to which the control is to be transferred. So this label indicates the offset address of an instruction to which the control is to be transferred. So after the execution of the JMP instruction, no flags are affected. Note that when this instruction is executed, the CS and IP are unconditionally modified to a new values of CS and IP corresponding to the location transfer. As you know that the combination of CS and IP will give you the instruction address. Then there are three types of JMP instruction: short jump, near jump, and far jump. Then what is short jump? The short jump is a 2-byte instruction that allows jumps or branches to memory locations within +127 and -128 bytes from the address following the jump. So that is, in short jump, address of the target must be within +127 and -128 bytes of the current IP instruction pointer. Then what is near jump? A near jump is a 3-byte instruction that allows a branch or a jump within ±32K bytes from the instruction in the current segment. That is, in near jump, the address of the target instruction must be within ±32K bytes from the instruction in the current code segment. Then what is far jump? Far jump is a 5-byte instruction. So the instruction length is 5 byte, that allows a jump to any memory location within the real memory system. That is, in far jump, the address of the target instruction can be located within the current code segment or in any another code segment. The short and near jumps are often called intra-segment jumps because they are jumps within the current code segments. The far jumps are often called inter-segment jumps. So jumps can happen within the current code segment or in another code segment. So let us discuss these three types of jump instruction in detail. First, the short jump. So short jumps are called relative jumps because they can be moved to any location in the current code segment without a change. That means the content of the instruction pointer can change without changing the content of the CS register. As you know that the instruction pointer register holds the address of next instruction. So the short jump instruction appears in figure below. So that means this is the machine code format of the short jump instruction. So the first byte is the opcode of short jump instruction, that is JMP. Opcode of JMP or object code of JMP is, or machine code of JMP is EB for short jump. Then this is followed by 8-bit displacement. Okay, this is the offset address of an instruction to which the control is to be transferred. Okay, so here example shows, this example shows how short jump instructions pass control from one part of the program to another. So a short jump to four memory locations, 1, 2, 3, 4, beyond the address of the next instruction. You can see here, this is the physical address where this jump instruction is stored. Then obviously, what is the content of CS? So CS will contain 1000H, that is the base address of the code segment. Then the physical address will become 10,000. Then IP, content of IP. IP stores the address of next instruction. So what is the address of next instruction? Offset address. Address of next, this is the next instruction after jump instruction. So offset address is 0002. Okay. So after executing this short jump instruction, which is a 2-byte instruction, okay, new IP is equal to old IP plus 4. Old IP is 2 plus 4 is 6. New IP value is equal to 006. Okay. Then how to calculate the physical address of the target instruction? Physical address is equal to CS into 10H plus this IP. So 10,000 into 10, sorry, 1000 into 10 plus this 6. So that will become 10,006. So this is where the jump occurs. Okay. So jump followed by the 8-bit displacement 04 will transfer control to the instruction at the address 10,006. We'll jump to here. Okay. So the control is transferred to the instruction at address 10,006. So one example of a short jump instruction, JMP, the mnemonic, followed by the directive short. So use short directive to force short jump. Okay. If you want to make use of a short jump, then use the assembly directive short, then followed by the label. So the label here is the next. And note that a jump is able to transfer control both forward and backward. Okay. Next type of jump instruction, near jump. The near jump is similar to the short jump except that the distance is farther. A near jump passes control to an instruction in the current code segment located within plus or minus 32 kilobytes from the near jump instruction. So as I said, the address of the target instruction must be located within plus or minus 32 kilobytes from the near jump instruction in the current code segment. And what is the length of the near jump instruction? The near jump is a 3-byte instruction that contains an opcode. So this is the opcode followed by a signed 16-bit displacement. So 16-bit displacement. So first low byte is stored and then the high byte of displacement is stored. So 3-byte instruction. This is first byte, this is second byte, this is third byte. Okay. Byte 1, byte 2, byte 3. So totally 3-byte. So here an example. A near jump that adds the displacement 0002H to contents of IP. Okay. To get the target address. Okay. So here at this address, we are making an call to near jump instruction. So JMP, so whose mnemonic is E9, sorry, opcode is E9 and mnemonic is JMP. And this is the 16-bit displacement. 16-bit displacement is 0002H. So first low byte will be stored. Low byte of the displacement is 02 and the high byte of displacement is 00. Okay, so this is a note that this is a 3-byte instruction. Okay, at 10,000, opcode of JMP will be stored. At 10,001, low byte of displacement will be stored. At 10,002, high byte of displacement will be stored. Okay, so this is a near jump. So then what is the content of CS now? CSC is 1000H, okay, which is the base address of the code segment. Okay. Then IP contains the address of instruction. What is the address of instruction? It should be 003. Make a note of this. There is a mistake here. Instead of 002, it should be 003. IP is 003. And then new IP is equal to what? Old IP plus the displacement. So old IP is 003 plus displacement is 0002. So then we will get new IP as 0005. It is not 006, it is 005. Then how do you get the 20-bit physical address? So CS into NH plus IP, offset address. So 1000 into 10 plus 005. Okay, so that will give the physical address as 10005. Okay. So a short jump instruction will transfer control to the new target address to another instruction whose target address is 10005. So example here, jump followed by the label. Label is next. Then another type of JMP instruction, for jump. A for jump instruction transfer control to the target location in different code segment. This is performed by loading CS with segment address in which the target address exists, and IP with instruction pointer with the offset address of instruction to which control is to be transferred in the new code segment. So CS holds segment address in which the target instruction exists, and IP the offset address of instruction to which the control is transferred. The target address loaded in CS and IP are part of the instruction itself. So this is a 5-byte instruction. So this diagram shows the machine code format of the for jump instruction. So the first byte will be the opcode of for jump EA, or machine code or object code, then followed by offset address, which is stored in IP, low byte of IP register and high byte of IP register, then followed by low byte of CS register and high byte of CS register. So this is an example of the for jump instruction. So a call is made in the current code segment and jump happens to the instruction at another code segment. Okay. So a for jump instruction replaces the contents of both CS and IP with 4 bytes following the opcode. Okay. So here you see here jump followed by load CS and IP with the target address. So IP will be loaded with first low byte. So this is 0127, and then the content of CS, which is A300, first low byte 00, then low byte of CS, then high byte of CS A3. So this will make a jump to the instruction at address A3127. How? Now, what is the new content of CS? It is A300. Okay. How to get the secret address of this? Add 10H, so that will become A3000 contributing secret address. To this, you add the new IP value, okay, which is 0127. So A3000 plus 0127 will give you the new physical address as A3127. Okay, so this is the target address of the next instruction to be executed. Okay. We'll jump to here. So an example of for jump, JMP. For is a directive, PTR pointer, and skip is a label. So this is for is an assembler, for PTR is an assembler directive to force the for jump. Then the next type of jump group instruction is conditional jump instructions. The conditional jump instruction transfer control to the address specified if some condition is met or satisfied, otherwise execution continues sequentially. Okay. So transfers control to another instruction if the condition is met, otherwise execution continues sequentially. The conditions here means the status of the condition flags. So the conditional jump instructions test the following flag bits. That means the conditional jump instruction test one of the following bits, flag bits. So sign flag, zero flag, carry flag, parity flag, overflow flag. If the condition under test is true, a branch to the label associated with the jump instruction occurs. If the condition is false, the next sequential instruction in the program executes. For example, a JC instruction, jump on carry, will jump if the carry bit is set. The flag bit tested by the JC instruction is carry flag. So if the carry bit is set, then jump occurs to the instruction, target instruction specified by the label. Otherwise, if the carry bit is not set, then the execution continues sequentially after the JC instruction. See, these are some of the, if you, this table gives the list of conditional jump instruction. So these are the instructions, which are the condition tested. So as I said, the condition instruction tests the following flag bits. Okay, these are the flag bits that are tested and the description. So the first conditional jump instruction, JA, stands for jump above. Jump if above, that means what is the condition tested? Carry flag is equal to zero and zero flag is equal to zero. That means JA will jump if carry flag is reset and zero flag is reset. Next conditional jump instruction, JAE, jump if above or equal. So JAE will jump to the label specified if the carry bit is reset. Then JB stands for jump below. JB will jump if carry flag is set. Then JBE, jump if below or equal. JBE will jump if carry flag is set or zero flag is set. JC stands for jump if carry. JC will jump if carry flag bit is set. Similarly, JE, jump if equal or JZ, jump if zero. Two mnemonics for the same instruction, JE or JZ. JE or JZ will jump if zero flag is set. JG, jump if greater than. JG will jump if zero flag is reset and send flag is reset. Jump if greater than or equal. JG will jump if send flag is equal to zero. Yeah. Like the remaining conditional jump instructions. JL for jump if less than. JLE, jump if less than or equal. JNC, jump if no carry. JNE, jump if not equal or jump if not zero. Two mnemonics for the same instruction. Jump if not overflow. Jump if not sign. Jump if no parity or jump if add parity. Jump on overflow. Jump on parity JP. JPE, jump if even parity. JS, jump on sign, and so on. Okay. So these are the conditional jump instructions. Thank you. That's it for the today's class.